one more hypothesis is intensity of incident radiation. So according to Einstein's picture of photoelectricity, intensity of incident radiation is defined as number of discrete energy levels crossing per unit area in unit time. So it is defined as number of discrete energy levels crossing per unit area in unit time. Like this we can define the intensity of the incident radiation. So whatever may be the intensity, if greater the energy, so greater the incident radiation. So greater the energy, so we can say greater the incident radiation. So at this point there is one more conclusion, that this energy is associated with the incident radiation. So that's why without energy and with energy there is a lot of variation between the threshold frequencies, almost U greater than U. One more hypothesis in this Einstein's photoelectric equation is, according to the photoelectrons, according to the Einstein's picture, the emission of electrons is spontaneous or instantaneous. The emission of electrons is spontaneous or instantaneous. So the instantaneous or spontaneous emission is the real picture of the Einstein's photoelectric equation. So whatever the matter of intensity, that means it is less intensity of the incident radiation, the electron takes more time, or more intensity or greater intensity, electron takes less time to pull out. It is not like that. Whatever may be the incident radiation's intensity, the emission is spontaneous. Whatever the intensity of incident radiation, the emission of electrons is same, means they will occupy the same timings. So whatever the energy, what is the energy of the emitted electrons? Okay, they have the energy of K max, but they will come out by overcoming the energy gap between the bond levels. So how it is computed? So inkoka incident radiation ela define chestamante ee discrete energy levels ennaithe oka unit area ki oka unit time lo cross avutunayo danni intensity of incident radiation ga Einstein define chesadu. So deen nunchi greater the energy, greater the incident intensity of the incident radiation. Inkoka hypothesis entante ఈ యొక్క ఎమిషన్ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ అనేది స్పాంటేనియస్గా ఉంటుంది, లేదా ఇన్స్టంటేనియస్గా ఉంటుంది. అంటే ఇన్సిడెంట్ ఎక్కువ, ఇంటెన్సిటీ ఎక్కువ అయితే ఎమిషన్ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ తక్కువ టైంలోనూ, లేదంటే ఇంటెన్సిటీ తక్కువ అయితే ఎక్కువ టైంలోనూ మ్యాటర్ కాదు. సో ఎంత ఇంటెన్సిటీ ఉన్నా సరే సేమ్ టైంలో సేమ్ నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ ఎమిట్ అవుతుంది, బికాస్ ఇట్ ఆక్యుపైస్ ది ఇన్స్టంటేనియస్ ఆర్ స్పాంటేనియస్ ఎమిషన్. సో సచ్ లైక్ దట్ వీ కెన్ డిఫైన్ ది ఐన్స్టీన్స్ ఫోటోఎలెక్ట్రిక్ ఈక్వేషన్. So K max is equal to h mu minus phi naught. This K max is equal to E V naught is equal to H mu minus phi naught. So from this we can write V naught is equal to H by E into mu minus phi naught, or V naught is equal to H by E into mu naught minus phi naught. This equation relates the mu naught V naught to mu naught. So by using this equation, this H by E is the slope of the graph. H by E is slope of the graph, where E is equal to 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 coulombs. Actually, one more great scientist, Millikan, tried to disprove this Einstein's hypothesis about the photoelectric equation. So that's why he has taken the many samples, metal samples and non-metal samples, and he has found the mu naught and phi naught, and we know the E value automatically. So, and voltage. So he has done the experiments between V naught, mu naught and phi naught by taking many samples, by doing experiments with many samples. So after all calculating, means this calculation was done by Millikan. Actually, Millikan tried to disprove the Einstein's hypothesis. Instead of disproving, he has proved it. So, by doing all these calculations, he has found the H value is constant and same for all metals. That's why its name is Planck's constant. So, the Planck constant value that was found by Millikan is 6.625 into 10 to the power minus 34 joule seconds. So like this, we can define the Planck's constant also from the photoelectric equation of the Einstein. So Mr. Millikan did proved this H value very abundantly and very frequently, and which is same for all metals. So like this, by all these hypotheses, we can say that Einstein's photoelectric equation and their hypothesis and their validation was proved. So by this, we can say that this Einstein's theory of the photoelectric effect is universal, not the classical theory. So K max is equal to H mu minus phi naught and okay. The K max as E V naught equal out to this. E V naught will be H mu minus phi naught. So V naught is equal to H by E into mu naught minus phi naught. So you could have V naught and the mu naught key proportional ground. So, ఈ V naught కి mu naught కి phi naught కి మధ్య ఉన్నటువంటి వాల్యూస్ తో డిఫరెంట్ మెటల్ శాంపిల్స్ తీసుకుని మిల్లికాన్ అనే సైంటిస్ట్ ఈ యొక్క ఐన్స్టీన్ ఈక్వేషన్ డిస్ప్రూవ్ చేయడానికి ట్రై చేశాడు. అతను డిస్ప్రూవ్ చేయకపోగా దాన్ని ప్రూవ్ చేయడం జరిగింది. సో అతను చేసిన ప్రూఫ్ను బట్టి అన్ని మెటల్ శాంపిల్స్కి కూడా హెచ్ వాల్యూ సేమ్గా వచ్చింది. దట్స్ వై దానికి ప్లాంక్స్ కాన్స్టెంట్ అని పేరు పెట్టడం జరిగింది. సో ఈ విధంగా అన్ని ఈక్వేషన్స్ ప్రూవ్ చేయబడ్డాయి కాబట్టి ఐన్స్టీన్స్ యొక్క ఫోటోఎలెక్ట్రిక్ ఈక్వేషన్ అనేది యూనివర్సల్లీ యాక్సెప్టెడ్ ఈక్వేషన్గా ఉంది. బికాస్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ హైపోథెసిస్ ఐన్స్టీన్ గాట్ నోబెల్ ప్రైజ్. సో ఆఫ్టర్ ద డిస్కవరీ ఆఫ్ ది ఐన్స్టీన్స్ ఫోటోఎలెక్ట్రిక్ ఎఫెక్ట్, దెర్ వాజ్ ఎ సబ్ కాన్సెప్ట్ విచ్ వాజ్ డిఫాల్టెడ్ ఇన్ ద ఎక్స్ప్లెనేషన్. So, according to the Einstein's hypothesis, a matter particle is associated with energy while it is coming out of a metal target when it is illuminated with a radiation. Is that energy is from the particle or the radiation? This is the question. So, Einstein has proved that the particle or the wave which is coming out of the metal surface in a form of radiation is a group of particles, and each particle is made up of a teeny particle called photon. So the wave energy which is released out of the metal surface is a combination of photon. If this photon has same energy, same momentum. So later, because of the discovery of this photon, this wave is called photonic wave. So Einstein was awarded with Nobel Prize. Millikan was also awarded with Nobel Prize, and this photonic concept was proved by and illustrated by A.H. Compton. making a H contact by the X-ray scattering experiment. So, what are the assumptions made by the photonic nature or photons of the this photoelectric effect? The first one is the radiation is behaving as if it is contains a particle called photon. The radiation behaves as if it is the combination of photons. Second one, each photon has fixed energy and fixed momentum. Or each photon has equal energy we can say that energy E is equal to h nu and equal momentum. So this momentum P is equal to h nu by c. The wavelength of the photon is also equal, that is lambda, and these photons are moving with velocity of light. The wavelength of photon is lambda and velocity c. Where c is equal to speed of light, that is 3 into 10 to the power of 8 meters per second. The fourth assumption, these photons are electrically neutral, so they cannot be deflected by electric and magnetic fields. Photons are electrically neutral. They can't be deflected by electric and magnetic fields. So the next point. So what is the next point is, in particle photon collision, total energy and momentum conserved. The particle photon collision, total energy and momentum is conserved. And the last assumption about the photons in the radiation is, these photons